Thank you, Madam Mayor. I would like to say to the continuing new cabinet member for Recruitment Services that paying the most doesn't always equate to getting the best. We paid quite high salaries prior to the scandal in Recruitment Services the first time around, and as Councillor Kelly has alluded to, we are now on the new operating model, because 8 months ago the operating model that you agreed has been decided is insufficient. Madam Mayor, I'd like to refer to one sentence in the book that I'll hopefully recall later in the debate this evening. I will refer to. There was one sentence I'd like to pull out to the Cabinet Member, and I quote, "In a period of financial stress, administrations have sometimes increased public sector wages less than the rate of inflation and economic growth." Madam Mayor, the advice that this council is getting to increase the salaries of those at the top is based on consultants' advice. Those consultants have a stake in recommending higher salaries. Penner, the company behind this particular appointment, is being paid, I understand, £12,000 per appointment recommended through this council. That's consultants being paid £12,000 simply for filling this vacancy, on top of the salaries that are proposed in this report. Madam Mayor, I would urge council to get a grip of this nonsense, to agree with Councillor Adrian Jones that these salaries are too high, and some council somewhere has to make a stand, and we can make a stand today by paying them this position, which we accept is important, which is why we as a Conservative group called for the original scandal in Children's Services to be looked into, so that we pay the salary less than the Prime Minister. I'm not sure Theresa May would apply for a job here, Councillor Jones. I'm not sure many people would at the moment because of the scandal in this department. What we need is the way this department is run. It's not the person at the top that runs the department necessarily, as we know. We've had some very good senior directors, but we've had problems within those departments. What we need is root and branch reform of these departments, starting from the top down, not necessarily paying the highest salaries based on advice from consultants who have their finger in the pie.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I appreciate the analogy has been made and obviously criticised about the Prime Minister's salary. If we take something a bit more local, Chief Constable's salary, for instance, a very pressurised job requiring a complete overview of the entire Merseyside area, about £140,000. So clearly we're in that kind of ballpark for some of the people that we're looking at. I accept that, you know, we have to pay some good salaries to get the best people, but it's interesting that we never seem to look internally. We're always very keen, as Councillor Lewis has pointed out, to get an external body to infer that a particular person who possibly reads the Guardian is actually likely to be offered a position. And I'm just wondering, and I'll just leave it with the thought, the Children's Services, I'm a little disappointed, Councillor Lewis, a lot of respect for you, but to actually infer that this is some sort of a political stunt on our side around something as important as Children's Services, I think is quite outrageous. And if you talk about how much you spend on senior salaries, how's that working out for you?
Okay, colleagues, now I'm conscious that this has happened quite an early now, and I'm minded to move to seconders. Okay, so I'm going to call Councillor Lakey now to second the Conservative.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I'll try not to take the 3 minutes in conscience of the people in the gallery. But I agree with everything that Councillor Billy said. Clearly, I don't sit on employment appointments as a norm. I deputise on this occasion. Absolutely amazed that, you know, a council that has reduced in size, that has shrunk in size, is saying, you know, we're losing a senior director on £124,000 plus per year. But hey, we're going to replace them with somebody on £115,000 and give them a different title. You know, which is going to cost the council additional cost of £120,284 a year. Why should this council be picking up the bill to strengthen the executive team? And as other people are saying, well, the people on the front line are being left alone. You know, we're building a team here, the executive team is being built to make castle. You know, they're really building the castle to strengthen their own. Let's all stand together, let's make our job pay well, and while we do have to have the best, I think we do have the opportunity to send the message to other councils that this council is not prepared to pay the money. I agree with what you said, Bernie, that you know, children are the most important thing. Nobody's going to dispute them at all, but at what cost?
We have the cost of the obstetric calls, we have the grooming scandal. Yes, we need somebody to deal with these things, we need somebody in place. As Councillor Burgess Joyce has alluded to, have we not brought somebody up from inside? Is there nobody inside that we can consider that wouldn't demand these high salaries? You know, football teams spend a fortune on players, but some of the best players come from within their training academies. Why don't we have something similar to this council? Why can't we bring people through the ranks that won't demand 150, 160, 170,000 pounds a year? If we need to pay that sort of money, then we need to pay it what needs to be capped. And if we need to pay, we need to find this. So let's not employ this other executive on 9,000 left from the ones he's left. Use that money towards some of the children's services. You can't have your cake and eat it. So second that amendment.
Thank you. Can I have the second of the Liberal Democrat
Council? Thank you, Madam Mayor. I think, as we've heard, nobody denies that the children's department deserves investment. But it can be a bit of a lazy option to say we'll only get the best if we recruit someone who most likely is already ahead of the children's department in another council. And that only that way will we find someone who can sort out the issues and our problems will all be solved. Well, as I think has already been pointed out, and as we know, it frequently doesn't work that way. We actually need a really effective team in the children's department. A team that works well at all levels, particularly the frontline social workers. And paying £140,000 to £155,000 to a director is no guarantee that we'll create the necessary team and departmental culture. It can, in fact, have exactly the opposite effect. There are some very talented deputy directors of children's services out there. We don't need to push up senior salaries. That's an easy option. Instead, let's look to building an effective department, a coordinated department, and above all, a department that achieves positive outcomes. Thank you, Madam Mayor.
Okay,
so
do we want to have the second of the original motion, Councillor George Davis, and want to call the meeting back. So we're going to have right to comply now, Councillor Phil Davis.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I'm inclined to agree with Councillor Adrian Jones about the benchmark and the Prime Minister. I just was reflecting on whether if this current Prime Minister was on a performance-related bonus, the issue may not be getting it this year. But I think seriously, Madam Mayor, I just ask members in this chamber to please get real.
Yeah.
In this debate, yeah. The problem that we've had actually in children's services for many, many years, and actually quite a few other departments, is we pay way below comparable local authorities. Yeah. You do any benchmarking exercise, you will see the evidence for this. And why is it? And that was one of the reasons why we lost some of our. That's one of the reasons why we've lost some of our best social workers, because neighbouring authorities pay money. And I don't blame them. I don't blame them for seeking a better salary. Now, you know, I'm the first to admit, Madam Mayor, that £140,000 is a huge amount of money. Certainly more money than ever I've earned in my career. It's a huge amount. But the reality is, we all know that this is the most difficult job in the local government to do today. It's the most difficult job because of all of the challenges that we've seen in other parts of the country, the various cases that we've read about and we've heard about in the press. This is hugely difficult, this job, and you are under scrutiny all the time. And that's why the best directors of children's services can command large salaries. That is the reality. And if, Madam Mayor, we were given this benchmarking information at the committee on the 27th of June. And just to read out a few of the comparisons. So, London boroughs, I know London's more expensive. London Borough of Rent, these are DCS posts, £187,000 a year. Moving on, Birmingham, £157,000. Buckinghamshire, 150,000, Essex, 149,000, Manchester, 145,000, Sandwell, 140,000. These are the salaries that directors of children's services can now command for reasons I've mentioned. So I just say, Madam Mayor, we do need to get real. Are we really seriously saying that if we pay the existing salary of 115,415, we'll be able to get a top-notch DCS? No, I don't think you need to be a genius to work out what I want. So it is passing taxpayers' money, I absolutely get that. But Bernie is absolutely right. We want to get the best possible candidate for this post. And I'm afraid all the evidence that I've seen suggests that this is the kind of salary band we will need to pay to get the best. And I do think, so that Bernie's right, we do deserve the best. So that's why I think we've made the decisions that we can. And I really do think that the party opposite is living in kind of cuckoo land if they think they can get a absolutely high quality, world class DCS on the salary, which is much lower than any of the benchmarking figures I've read out. So I think there's a very strong case. In terms of other points that colleagues have made in the amendments, we have saved money on management in this authority. Most recently, in the last budget, we saved £300. So we do look at management. And Madam Mayor, I'll take the lessons from the party opposite about the importance of funding frontline services. It's their government that's starting off. So we won't take any lessons from that. Councillor Kelly's point about the managerial structure. I trust the Chief Executive. I trust the Chief Executive to provide a managerial structure that's fit for purpose. Sorry, Councillor Kelly. You're not the Chief Executive, you're a councillor, and I prefer to be advised by the person who's paid to advise us on these matters. So, Madam Mayor, we will not, for the reason I've mentioned, we will not be supporting either of these amendments. And please, let's just be realistic about what we need to do to get the best, particularly Director of Children's Services. It's the most important appointment we will be making this budget for years to come. So please support the administration reject these amendments. Thank you very much.
We'll now move to
Recruitment.
Can I please take the vote for the amendments? So all those in favour of the amendment moved by Councillor Hillcrest, please indicate. All those against? Votes in favour, 25. Votes against, 35. Abstentions, 1. That motion is lost. We're going to now move to the Conservative amendment. Okay, now I'm going to take the card vote, so please be very quiet and listen for the amendment.
Against.
That's Chris Jones.
Against.
That's Tony Jones.
Against.
That's Kelly.
Four.
That's
Four.
That's Green.
Against.
That's Lewis Jones.
Again.
That's Green.
Four.
That's Cruz.
Four.
That's Spencer.
Yeah.
That's Walter Smith.
Against.
Against.
That's Stapleton.
Yes.
That's Stewart.
Against.
That's Sullivan.
Against.
That's Sykes.
Four.
That's Fisher.
Against.
That's Ward.
Against.
That's Watt.
Four.
Against.
That's Irene Williams.
Against.
That's Jerry Williams.
Against.
That's Steve Williams.
Four.
That's Williamson.
Against.
That's Ward.
Against. Abstentions 1, that amendment is lost.
Right. Yeah.